Genius Brands International, million-dollar stock maker, or a bag of empty promises. Please do me a favor and click the like button below this video now. This helps us get these videos out, and every single like really does help. So the CEO of Genius Brands International likes to think of themselves as Netflix for kids in the educational space. And other than a few moderately successful shows like Llama Llama that shows on Amazon Prime, most of their shows are actually pretty unknown. So I think the analogy is probably a little bit off. You know, they've got shows like The Secret Billionaires Club that includes Warren Buffett that is just, you know, so secretive, nobody actually knows about it. And then if you go and look at the history on the share price of Genius Brands, you'll see there's been a massive drop off since 2012. I mean, coming off highs, you know, in the area of like 80 bucks all the way down to almost a penny stock, 187. So we have to ask ourselves, is this company sitting on something that we don't know about, or is it really just in the final stages of breathing, final stages of survival? Well, let's have a look. Market cap, 560 million. And then if we head across to statistics, something that's really alarming for a company that's been going this long, profit margin, 0%, operating margin, negative 472%, and not surprisingly, no dividend. Then if we go and have a look at the actual balance sheet, we can see total assets, 27,713 in 2017, and then 29,413. So a small increase over the last 3 years. And then if we go and have a look at liabilities, 12,673 in 2017, all the way up to 23,27. So seriously, very alarming how the liabilities have increased. And not surprisingly, the equity left in the company has just been going down year on year on year. So what we can see is a company here that's just pretty much burning through cash. And then if we head across to the income statement, we can see total revenue. Also, extremely interesting picture here. If we look at 2017, 5,336, and then all the way up to 993,452 in 2018, their biggest year in the last few years, and then bang, straight back down in 2019 to 5,908. And what's more concerning is if we look at the actual gross profits. Gross profits, obviously I'm guessing here that this income would have been of some kind of show licensing fees came in, and then obviously just huge, huge costs in terms of production and actually getting their product out. And then if we go across and we have a look at the actual cash flow statement, something that is super concerning over here is cash from operations all in the negative. -7,187, -8,088, and then -6,251, and just negative trends all the way through. If we go look at capital expenditure, huge capital expenditure for this company in 2017, almost halved in 2018, halved again in 2019, and then doubled in the last trailing 12 months. So it seems like they really, really are fighting to be in the game. They're trying to do whatever they can, but they're burning through cash at a hell of a rate. And this shows in their free cash flow. Negative numbers all the way through from 2017. We take the last trailing 3 years, and we can see just negative free cash flow, non-existent. So if you guys have been watching this channel for a while, you know I have a 12-point checklist that I evaluate all shares on, that we look to see if there's any underlying value. So currently trading at $1.87, market cap of 560 million. They currently do have a PE ratio below 25, pretty much by default, so they score there. Profit margin greater than 10%, unfortunately not, criteria not met. And then if we look at assets greater than liabilities, they do indeed have equity in the company. However, it has been declining year on year. So that's a major point of concern. Total revenue is not up for the last 3 years. Gross profit is surprisingly up. Operating income for the last 3 years is, you know, obviously non-existent. Net income, non-existent. And then cash from operating activities for the last 3 years, slightly up, but in the negative numbers. So it's a major, major concern. So they're kind of getting a point here by default. Free cash flow growth is looking a little bit better over the last 3 years, but again, negative numbers. So a major, major point of concern. And then number of shares outstanding going down. They've just been issuing more shares through the process. And I'm guessing this is really because they're burning through cash and they absolutely needing investor funding to stay alive. And then if we look at the dividend cost, purely based on the fact that they don't pay a dividend, they meet the criteria here. And then, you know, as we've seen, the share price has just been obliterated over the last 8 years. So definitely this share price has not doubled in the last decade. So where we're currently standing, we have a buy score of 50%. We have a sell score of 50%. So slap bang in the middle. The question is, do we put our money into the stock? Well, I've looked at the company. I've looked at the fundamentals. There is nothing here in the fundamentals that paints a positive picture. For me personally, what I'm seeing here is a company that is burning through investors' cash to stay alive, almost trying to fight to the next opportunity. And for that reason, I have to say this is a no-go for me. It may very well surprise all of us. They may turn this company around, but based on what I'm seeing here in the fundamentals, I'm out. If you love money, creating wealth, and want financial freedom, join our Global Money Tribe by smashing that subscribe button now. And be sure to turn on the notifications by clicking on the bell icon. And because I know you need a little extra motivation, every month I'm going to give away a signed copy of my book, The Money Secret, along with some really cool channel merch to our active subscribers. So smash that subscribe button now.